Turnbuckle Tavern's YouTube page. Today we are talking about the New Japan G1 Climax results from yesterday. Before we get into the video, though, make sure you guys click on the link in the description below to subscribe to the YouTube page, follow the link to our podcast page. You can subscribe, rate, and review there, our Twitter, our Instagram, and our Pro Wrestling Tees page. But now let's get into it. We had some results from New Japan, the G1 yesterday.
Yeah, they wrapped up the G1, which had been going on for a while, and Kota Ibushi ended up winning for the second year in a row by defeating Sonata in a 35-minute mat classic. It was a really good G1 this year. The one thing I'll say, I feel like it, with them not being on Access TV anymore,
yeah,
I feel like it didn't have as much mainstream coverage. Not that it's ever been mainstream here in America, but I felt like it didn't feel as big as, you know, years before.
Right.
And maybe that's because some of their talent, you know, kind of jumped ship a few years ago and went to make AEW, and, you know, Kenny was always a big draw in it. And I do like that Ibushi, they're building this young guy, and he, you know, he's got the back-to-back wins. Me personally, I thought they were they just put the big belt on Evil not too long ago, which he since lost it back to Naito. But I thought with Evil and Jay White kind of being kind of not in battle, but there, you know, there's a who's the leader of Bullet Club question.
Right.
I thought we were going to get a Jay White versus Evil in the finals of the G1 Climax.
Yeah.
But I think they're going to possibly build, I think their next event might be called Power Struggle.
Okay. Which, yeah, I'm not really sure.
Yeah, I think it's Power Struggle, and which makes it, that to me says we may get a storyline between Jay White and Evil. But another big thing that came out of the aftermath of the G1 Climax was Will Ospreay turning heel during the match between Okada and Ospreay. Ospreay's real life girlfriend, who's been in AEW, who wrestles in Japan, she made her New Japan debut and came to ringside with Ospreay, B. Priestley. Now, as Okada had his money clip submission locked onto Ospreay, Priestley entered the ring, kind of distracted the ref, and then Oka made his return, and I guess they're calling him the Great Okan now. I guess a play on like Genghis Khan or, well, okay. He hits Okada with an Iron Claw slam, gets the victory for Will Ospreay, and I guess they've formed a faction now, and they're calling themselves the Empire, which is Okan, Priestley, and Ospreay. Which Ospreay as a heel is interesting to me. I want to see how, because he's been one of their top talents for several years, and so we could see where that goes. But they've got a lot of talent right now that they're trying to still get their feet under them. You know, obviously all their homegrown guys, Okada, Naito, Tanahashi. But, you know, you've got your Jay Whites, your Evils, your Ospreys. Even Jeff Cobb was in the G1 this year, which was awesome.
Yeah.
So it was a really good G1, but I like seeing what they're doing, because with all the kind of rumors and rumblings of them possibly working with AEW, even if you're not a fan of New Japan, it's good to keep up with their product just so you kind of know who the major players are. So for all the American fans that, you know, it's right now with them not being on Access, it is harder to follow them, but you can get the New Japan app. Hell, just read the results if you can't watch, and kind of brush up on it and get familiar with their roster. So that way, you know, if this partnership with AEW does end up coming into fruition, you know who some of these players are.
Yeah, full disclosure, I have lacked on keeping up with New Japan ever since I've not been able to see the programming, and it's left on me, which it is on me to go through and read those results and things like that. But it has been something that I've been lacking that I need to get back into familiarizing myself with, because I do feel like this kind of partnership is going to happen.
Their wrestling is some of the best wrestling in the world.
And traditionally it's always been that way.
Yeah, that King's Road strong style, hard to beat. But yeah, great G1. Interested to see how these guys continue to grow and where they send these storylines, and interested to see how this whole New Japan AEW thing may shake out in 2021.
Yeah, I'd love to see how that, especially with what we've talked about before with Omega and his year in 2021 and his history with New Japan anyway. So you guys go in the comment section, let us know how you're watching, how you're keeping up with New Japan. And if you're not, let us know if you plan on doing that. Like I said before, I don't know if I told you before, but click the bell up in the corner so you know when we're coming back with more videos, and we'll be back with more soon.